What was the biggest coincidence that made you question the fabric of reality? One time, me and my dad were discussing his friend while out driving at night without many other cars on the road. As we were talking, we pulled up to a red light, and the car waiting in front was my dad's friend. He didn't even live close to there. My friend and I were on a road trip a few years ago and needed a place to stay. We both told each other we had a friend in the city we were going through, so we figured we'd be able to crash with one of them. Turns out our two friends were roommates and had both been telling each other that they had a friend coming to town soon. When I was in year 7, I used to always giggle when a kid's name got called over the loudspeaker to go to the office cause it was a name that sounded rude. I didn't know this kid, they were in a different year level to me, never met them, just remembered the name cause it was funny. Fast forward to now, I'm in my 30s with kids and it turns out that funny named kid is my daughter's best friend's mom. One morning, as my father and I were leaving our apartment to head to school, he was a teacher at the same high school I attended, I paused at the door, then went back inside to the change bowl and scooped out a fistful of coins. My dad asked why and I didn't really have a reason, I just said, "We're gonna need this." I wasn't exactly a coherent morning person, so he shrugged it off. As we were driving in, we passed the grocery store, which reminded him he needed tape for his class for some project they were doing. We went in, got to the register, and as the tape was rung up, he realized he didn't have his wallet on him. I said, "I got this," and put down the money I had taken earlier. It was exact, to the penny. Another time, I went on a long walk and talk with my soul. We were talking about the soul and speculating about its transcendent nature for the duration of the walk. As we headed home, we crossed the street and my soul gestured at the car waiting at the light. Its license plate was Soul. When my brother and I were little, we went to my aunt's lake house for winter break. One of my aunt's friends invited us over to dinner. It was my best friend's family who had family on the same lake and was vacationing at the same time. I was at SeaWorld and we were there with my kids and grandma. We went into an outdoor water show and sat in the stands. I was sitting higher up the stands and my mother-in-law was near the front, which was a splash zone. She didn't want to get wet, so I had to give up my sweet spot to have her sit there, and I moved down to the front. Before I could even get to my new seat, a bird flew overhead and dropped a fat turd on her head. Dodged a bullet. Several years ago, I had a husky that was getting on in years. I was very in tune with him, enough that I knew which whines or cues meant which need or want. He had a particularly unique one that signaled when he needed a bathroom break. As he got older, he started needing to go outside in the middle of the night too. Old man problems, am I right? Lol, when he got to be a bit past 11 years old, my fiancé and I started noticing that I could hear him from across the house. Then, we noticed that he never failed to wake me up at night, even though he wouldn't come in the bedroom to get me, just meet me at the back door. One day she was sitting on the couch with the dog and watching TV, while I was taking a nap in the other room. I had sound dampening headphones in, with light music going to help drown out distractions. I woke up to the sound of this dog making a loud enough racket to wake me up through all of those precautions, pulled on pants and shoes and stepped into the next room, where my partner asked what was wrong. I said the dog was whining. She disagreed, so we looking to the dog, who made the tiniest, "I need outside," whine, before getting up and going to the back door. It was surreal, and then it happened more. I'd be outside in my workshop and hear the dog whine. Within 2 minutes, my partner would be bringing the pup out to do his business. To the day he died, I could tell what that dog needed, when he needed it, regardless of distance. Currently, I have a 2-year-old husky that I've started hearing at different volumes than my partner. I'm not psychic, but I think that just maybe, some dogs are. Through a series of weird circumstances, I had never met my best friend's older sister's best friend, despite me also being very close to the sister and being at their house all the time. We finally met one night and we were all sitting around the kitchen table talking. She and I are both major cat people and we were talking about our past and current cats. I told her the crazy and horrible story of how my cat had been missing since the night of my senior prom, 3 weeks prior. He was 13 and I was devastated. I showed her a picture of him and she said something along the lines of, "I don't want to get your hopes up, but he looks a lot like this cat my dad started feeding in our backyard about 3 weeks ago." He didn't have a collar, so my dad thought he was a stray, but he is pretty chonky. It was like 11 p.m., but my friend and I immediately jumped into my car and drove over to the girl's house. As soon as I got out of the car and yelled his name, he came running. He was missing a tooth from a previous adventure, so I pried his mouth open to be 100% sure it was him. The friend lived about 3 miles from me. After we worked out what had happened and how huge of a coincidence it was, my mind was completely blown. The stars aligned so perfectly for me to get my baby boy back. I still get goosebumps when I think about it. The Jim twins. Look it up. Two twins who were given up for adoption at birth, given the same first name by their adoptive parents, took family vacations to the same beach, married women with the same name, divorced, their second wives' names were off by one letter, both served as volunteer sheriffs, both were into carpentry, both smoked the same brand cigarettes and drank the same brand beer. Dreaming about someone I didn't see in years only to meet them by coincidence a week later. The year J.R.R. Tolkien died is the One Ring verse backwards. 1973. 3 rings for the Elven Kings. 7 for the Dwarf Lords. 9 for mortal men. 1 ring to rule them all. I always thought this was bizarre, lol. I had a dream that a friend of mine and I were living in a loft-style apartment with exposed brick and told him about it at band practice. He enjoyed the term, exposed brick, and used it, metaphorically, in a song he was writing. Fast forward 7 years later, both of us living in separate areas than we grew up in all those years, multiple career changes for both, and by coincidence, we both ended up back in the same, different than we grew up in, town. A guy the first went to college with showed me his apartment, of which he loved and had a vacancy in their building. But I needed a roommate to help foot the bill. You guessed it. That same guy the first had the dream about was looking for a new place to rent. This place had exposed brick and was one of few in the area, at that time. Several years ago I was at a coffee shop with some friends and one of them had an iPad. Another friend went to unlock it and asked him what his 4-digit unlock code was. So I just blurted out 4 random digits pretending like I knew it, and it actually worked. I had never unlocked it before or knew of the same numbers being used for anything else, or his phone number, etc. Last week I am at work doing a job. My coworker strikes up a conversation with the homeowner at the job site and mentions that his parents live across the street from him. He also asks how long he had lived there. Homeowner responds that it has only been a few months. He just moved to the city from small town several hours away. Coworker laughs and says he was born and raised in that town. Then asks, do you know the miniplex at the corner of X Street and Y Street? I lived right across from that. Homeowner looks confused. Do you mean at 103 X Street? That was my house. They talked more, and discovered that my coworker's parents had sold their house to this homeowner when they moved to the city. He lived there for 15 years. And then sold it to move to the same city, across the street from the previous owners. Small world. This guy the first went to grade school and high school with, an acquaintance at best. I've seen him in 5 different locations in different countries throughout the last 15 years. Disney World when I was a kid. Some beach bar in Thailand. The Bean in Chicago. A pub in Budapest. A library in San Jose, Costa Rica. We've become friends due our love of traveling, but neither of us post on social media and neither of us communicated with each other our plans to travel. We never talked outside of the random meetings. Now if I see him, it's like the world wants us to have a beer together. Haha. Was working grocery store as a summer job while I finish up one of my remaining classes before I graduated college. Management was fucking with my schedule and hours, didn't respect the fact that I had class, and weren't willing to work with me about cutting my hours down a little, working 20 instead of 25 hours a week. Was thinking about quitting and went to talk to my manager in her office where she said, I guess you will have to pick employment or your class, now go help up front. Next customer came up line, didn't know my manager and I just had this conversation, and said, you deserve more than this job. Tell them to fuck off. So I turned off my light, went back to manager and said, I pick my class. I quit, got that customer's number now and tutor them with their classes, make more, and feel better. I had a childhood best friend that I'd known since before we started school who moved away when I was about 12 and briefly kept in contact before not speaking for years. During university, 19 to 20 years old, I went to go visit another school friend at their uni and we went into town to the shops. As we were looking at some games, my friend looked up and said, "Is that who I think it is?" And my old friend was standing 2 feet away from me. I passed out after receiving a flu shot when I was 28. The nurse who helped me up kept asking if I wanted my mom. It seemed like a really weird thing to offer an adult woman. The option to have her mother phoned and brought in. So I was really confused and getting progressively more annoyed at her repeatedly asking. Until my mom walked up to me. She had the appointment after mine to get vaccinated. The nurses assumed we had come together, but neither of us knew about the other's appointment, and we lived an hour away from each other in different cities. I used to host trivia at this cool little bar, restaurant. A group would come in consistently, so I eventually became friends with them. One bloke in particular, Matt, and I had a lot in common because we worked in the same industry and love video games. The group and I spent the next couple of months hanging out after trivia at my place and getting to know one another. One night my family comes to trivia, so when they arrived I go over and say hi, which is when my sister points over to a table and says, "I think that kid played at my wedding." My sister is a police officer and got a call one day that kids were maybe doing drugs at an abandoned warehouse. Turns out there were three young boys shooting a music video who nearly shit their pants when they saw cops. Once the misunderstanding was cleared up, they were just chatting to the police, and that's when my sister asked them if they could play my wedding. The boys were relieved they weren't getting arrested, so they said yes, of course, because it's a paid gig. This was probably 7 years ago at this point. One of the boys at the warehouse playing cello was Matt. I go over and ask if he plays the cello, if he had a misunderstanding with the police, and if he played at a wedding in 2013. He replied yes and asked how the fuck I knew that. I ask if it's that person over there while pointing to my sister. He says, "Ah, yeah, that's her," and waves. I tell him that's my sister. Both our heads just about exploded. Last week, I was driving my dog home from the vet. While turning onto my street, I noticed a woman sitting at the intersection while her collie sat in one place defiantly. 20 minutes after I got home, my mother asked if my dog should be having any kind of reaction to anything. I didn't know, but after seeing my dog, I knew something was terribly wrong. I rushed her back to the vet where they stabilized her. She had gone into anaphylaxis as a result of a shot she received maybe half an hour earlier. I called mom to tell her and she gasps, "We were out front earlier and a woman had to stop walking with her collie." She told us all about how her dog recently went into anaphylaxis. I was hanging out with four buddies, and looked at my phone and said, "Huh, my phone's at 69% charge, nice." The other three looked at their cell phones and also had 69% charge. It was the weirdest coincidence and we all started laughing. Buddy number four was at 80% though, he could not join in on the fun. I had two chargers by my bed. One was plugged in while the other wasn't. I grab one and plug in my iPad, seeing the green battery, so I knew it was charging. A moment later I look down and realize I plugged in the wrong one, and then the iPad stopped charging. It was the weirdest thing. Slightly silly one emo, but in college I was assigned a 4-digit numbered mailbox. I began using it as a PAN number for credit cards and such. Imagine my husband's, then boyfriend's, surprise a few years later when I had him enter my PIN number to pull money from the ATM while I was sick, and it was the last 4 digits of his social security number. I know it is just probability, but it was so weird. So, I was reading about a fairly well-known cold case not in my area. The woman killed looked a lot like me, and I found out while digging that she went to the same small college as my dad. They were in an extracurricular together and our family photo album has a group photo where they are next to each other. Finally, something I can comment on. My house, a cousin's house in my home country and a cousin's house in Paris all caught on fire on the same day. My sister and my cousin back home both caused the fire almost identical fashion, playing with fire matches. We know it was the same day as, when my mother called her sister, my auntie, to let her know on the day after it had happened, she said the same had happened to them. As for my cousin, family in Paris, not sure if theirs was the same day, but was definitely within the same week or so, they had sadly lost two lives. My auntie and my cousin, who was a kid and was the same age-ish as my sister and cousin who both caused the fires in each home. My uncle who survived had a really tough life thereafter. So, yeah, I tend not to believe in coincidences as much as I do fate. I was crossing the street after leaving a store and had the strangest feeling I was going to break my ankle, so carefully avoided a vehicle coming my way. That evening I went to pick up Thai food, fell leaving the restaurant on less than a 4-inch step, and shattered my ankle to the point of needing surgery and after a year haven't fully healed. This isn't as crazy as other ones I read, but it's mine. We probably scared the shit out of some poor old couple while on a road trip. We were going to my grandmother's, and we followed the same freaking car for over 4 hours, and eventually stopped at the same restaurant, and the same gas station, and only ever stopped when we pulled into my grandma's residential neighborhood. My wife and I were looking to hire a caterer for our wedding, and when we met, my wife and her started talking about their lives a bit. Turns out they had both literally grown up on the same street, in a city of 10 million people, on the other side of the world. Both had left the city around a decade before immigrating to our current country. They knew the same people, had hung out at the same coffee place, attended the same church. They even used to grab mangoes off the same large tree that hung over the wall of one of the large houses in the neighborhood. But they had never met one another until meeting on almost the exact opposite side of the planet, in a small town of about 50,000 people. A couple of years ago, I was visiting my hometown and decided to sit on a bench at my favorite park. As I was sitting, I felt something land on my head. Bird poop. After heading home and washing my hair, I went back into town. While I walked around, I watched as a guy got hit with a drop of sky shit. As I was laughing about the apparent irritable bowel syndrome of the birds in my town, a bird flying right over me drops a fat shit on my head. I dialed my mom on my mobile when I was on public transport and accidentally swapped two numbers around. The person I called was on the same carriage. At 10 I flew from west side of North America to the east to stay with my grandparents for the summer. They took me to a small touristy town to see trains. While hiking down the street we passed a kid in my class. Not friends but knew each other. We both just casually said hello and continued. But each of our grandparents freaked the fuck out. Wait, how do you know that kid? Didn't faze me then, but 40 years later it weirds me out. Thanks for watching. See you later.